Hello friends and welcome back to the Business Guruji. Please click on the subscribe button to get the latest videos from our channel. Today we will see the use of conditional formatting in Excel. So conditional formatting allows you to automatically apply formatting such as colors, icons and data bars to one or more cells based on the cell value. So we have taken a sample to show the demonstration of conditional formatting. We have name of five salesmen and we have their targets for the day, and the their sales value, actual sales value, is shown in column number D. So let us see how we can use conditional formatting for better representation of their sales, visually appealing to the target audience. So because we will be creating multiple conditional formatting, so let me copy this sales value in new column. So first of all, we'll go to conditional formatting, and you can see there are different formatting tabs. So we have highlight cells rule. So this conditional formatting is used to highlight based on the given rules: greater than, less than, between, equal to, or it can also be used for a text, or it can also be used to identify a duplicate value. The second type of conditional formatting is top or bottom rules. So you can identify top 10% or based on your value. If you decide to identify top 5, you can also choose that based on percentages, bottom 10 items, bottom 10%, or above and below average. Then you also have data bars, which will give you the relative positioning into each cell based on the numbers that they have. So it can be either a gradient fill or a solid fill based on your requirement. Then we also have color scales. So based on your requirement, this color scale changes the value to red, amber and green, or in case the lower is the preferable number, it will change the lowest in green, and this one will change the highest as green. So you can use different types of scale, and also you can go to more rules to change this. Then you also have icon sets, where you can use icon bars to identify high and low based on your requirement. Also, in case these rules are not enough for your requirement, you could always go to new rule to create new rules. So we'll take the example one by one for each of these rules. So first of all, we'll go to highlight cells. So let me highlight those values which are greater than, say, 500. And the fill would be a green fill. I can also define a multiple rule on this. So I can also highlight cells which are less than, say, 500. And the range would be a light red. Now, if you see, I have chosen the value greater than 500 and less than 500. So the exact value of 500 doesn't lie in any of the cells, hence it is remained uncolored. So it is very important that you choose your formula carefully while applying. Let us take other examples as well. I have copied the formula. So in case you want to highlight it between, I will leave it up to you to continue with this. Let us go to identifying of top and bottom rules. So let me identify the top two, and I will put it as a green fill. So obviously we would not like to have 2550 or the total into this. Let me select only the range of the sales. Simultaneously, we would also like to identify who are our bottom two salesmen. So we'll go to bottom two and we'll go a red color. So here we have identified the top two and the bottom two. Let us take more examples of conditional formatting. Let us apply the data bars, and the data bars would be based on color select. So if you see 800 is having the maximum value, hence it is considered as 100. Rest others are moved accordingly. We can also select color bars based on your requirement, and it will give you a beautiful look. Now we can also select a rule wherein we want to identify which of the salesmen has not met his target. If you see, John's target was 450, but his sales was 500, so he is definitely meeting his target. Similarly with Andrew, though his sales are only 350, but he is still meeting his target. Unlike Harry, whose sales were 800, but whose target was 800, but his sales is only 600. So we would like to identify those salesmen who have not met their targets. So this we can do by using a formula. So we can go to and say new rule. So if you go to new rule, you see that there are different options available. So format all sales based on their values, format only sales that contain say ABC, format only top or bottom ranks values. So these are mostly the ones which we have already seen from the tab. The only tab which is use a formula to determine is the one which we will be using here now. So we will put the formula equal to value will be I5. So I will unlock the freeze from here is less than say the target value, which is C5. I will remove the freeze. So this value is if I5 is less than C5, if my sales is less than my target. So if for this particular case it is not, so it will not return any value, but yes, in case it is there, I will go to format and I will go to red fill. So you can see there are number different things. You can change the number, font, you can also choose a strike through option if you want, then put a different border, or you can go a different fill. So for now I'm choosing a red color fill so that I can identify that the target was not met. I will press OK, and I will, so this is only done for this cell, I will go to format painter and I will select everything. So you see the sales of Harry was less than his target, and similarly the sales for Jennifer was less than her target. That's why they are being highlighted as red. Now I can also use another rule on the same formula to highlight the ones who have attained their target. Similarly, I'll go equal to I5. I'll remove the freeze using F4 function is greater than C5. Again, I'll remove the freeze, and if this condition is fulfilled, it should be colored as green. I'll again go to format painter and copy this to the whole formula. Now you can easily identify who all have met their target and who all have missed their target. So this gives a visually appealing look to your data, and you can easily identify the action items that you want to focus. So friends, this is all for this video on conditional formatting. So we'll come back to you on more videos on Excel and other career aspects. So stay tuned. Bye bye.